Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back again with some latest updates for you. We'll begin with Elon Musk's recent update on Starlink's cyber defense system, then we'll discuss Russia-China collaboration in space, and we'll wrap up with the development of a new production facility in Starbase. So let's get started with Elon Musk warning that their Starlink system may become an easy target in Ukraine while SpaceX is focusing on strengthening Starlink's cyber defense system. Recently, Elon Musk has warned that the chance for their Starlink satellite broadband system in Ukraine to become easy targets is constant as the situation worsens with ongoing Russian invasion. The recent warning from Musk had come forth after an Internet Security Analytic Organization had warned that devices that use satellite communications could potentially become beacons for Russia to use as targets for air attacks. Following this warning, Musk had tweeted to his users, "Important warning, Starlink is the only non-Russian communication system still working in some parts of Ukraine, so probability of being targeted is high. Please use with caution." Musk suggested to Starlink users in Ukraine to turn on Starlink only when needed and place antenna as far away from people as possible. He added that users should place light camouflage over antenna to avoid visual detection. In the most recent update from Musk, SpaceX is now concentrating to make Starlink more resilient against cyber attacks and also against signal jamming. He wrote, "SpaceX reprioritized to cyber defense and overcoming signal jamming. Will cause slight delays in Starship and Starlink V2. According to Musk, this move from SpaceX has come forth after some Starlink terminals near conflict areas were being jammed for several hours at a time. He also gave a relief by stating, "Our latest software update bypasses the jamming. Am curious to see what's next." Last week, Musk had announced that the company had activated its services in Ukraine and SpaceX was sending more terminals to the country. This announcement arrived as a response to a Ukraine government official who had requested Musk to provide the nation with additional Starlink stations. Ukraine's Vice Prime Minister Mykhailo Fedorov has then also thanked Starlink for keeping their cities connected and emergency services saving lives. In the face of a worsening war situation, Ukraine is facing a serious shortage of water and electricity. But government official has stated that they will require generators to keep Starlink service online. But according to an update from Musk, Starlink's power consumption rate has decreased, thus providing good connectivity with less power. Dmitry Rogozin, head of the Russian Space Agency, commented on Musk's help toward Ukraine that, "When Russia implements its highest national interests on the territory of Ukraine, Elon Musk appears with his Starlink, which was previously declared as purely civilian. Here is this mud opened himself." In a clever reply, Musk stated, "Ukraine's civilian internet was experiencing strange outages, bad weather perhaps, so SpaceX is helping fix it." On Saturday, Musk stated that some governments, but not Ukraine, had told SpaceX to block Russian news sources on their Starlink satellite broadband service, but he said, "We will not do so unless at gunpoint. Sorry to be a free speech absolutist." Let's move to our next update, where Russia is trying to have collaboration with China to promote their future space plans. On the 26th of February, Russian space agency head Dmitry Rogozin said that the sanctions imposed by Western countries would create a drastic fall in the supplies of microelectronics and other equipment, which are of utmost need to develop any satellite or launcher vehicle. Rogozin said, "With all our efforts to promote the Russian national microelectronic industry, it's impossible to produce everything. We have excellent relations with China, and we will solve these problems. And in the face of reducing cooperation with Western countries, Russian space agency Roscosmos is now looking forward to China as a supplier of crucial electronic components and equipment, and also as a partner in their upcoming high-grade missions." According to some reports of the 27th of February, China seeks not to be helping Russia directly in matters of space development. Possibly this step was taken by China to prevent the threat of sanctions from other countries. Some sources state that if China continues business with Russia, then Chinese banks and other Chinese companies would draw sanctions upon themselves from other countries, and they'll also lose their effortless admission to the U.S. financial system. Already in January this year, the U.S. State Department has imposed sanctions on some subsidiary companies of the China Aerospace Science and Technology Corporation and the China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation. Report says that those sanctions were issued under the Arms Export Control Act and the Export Administration Act. So this puts China under great pressure. Many sanctions have come upon Russia after they invaded Crimea in 2014. Since then, Russia had turned their attention to Chinese aerospace companies for cooperation in space. But the invasion of Ukraine is having far greater consequences. According to sources, it's expected that Russia's upcoming missions could now see Chinese collaboration in place of American involvement. As per Rogozin, the Russian Venera D mission, which is planned to Venus, will have no involvement of U.S. except any minor discussions with NASA on the mission. Presently, U.S.-Russia cooperation in the International Space Station operations may remain normal, but any further cooperation may come to an end. On the 26th of February, Roscosmos tweeted, citing a statement by Rogozin, that the agency is suspending cooperation with European partners in organizing space launches from French Guiana. On the 28th of February, the European Space Agency said that it is very unlikely that its ExoMars mission will launch this September because of sanctions on Russia and also the Ukraine crisis. It seems that China is being extremely careful in taking their steps in this Russia-Ukraine conflict. Neither have they tagged Russia's actions in Ukraine as an invasion, nor have they shown full collaboration in matters of space and other affairs to Russia. Thus, it seems they're trying to be neutral in this conflict. On the 28th of February, Wang Wenbin, an official of the Chinese Foreign Ministry, stated that though Russia and China were on their way to have close cooperation, they're not allies. Wenbin also said, "China and Russia are comprehensive strategic partners of coordination. Our relationship features non-alliance, non-confrontation, and non-targeting of any third party. China's position on the Ukraine issue is consistent. We always decide on our position and policy based on the merits of the matter itself." Rogozin stated that he'll send a team of officials to initiate negotiations with Beijing for the management and mutual technical support for missions to deep space. In the last few years, Sino-Russian cooperation has grown with a good lead. Agreements for cooperation on the Chinese Chang-6 and Chang-7 and Russian Luna 27 missions and a proposed joint international lunar research station have already been carried out. And as per sources, launches for that projected space station will start from the early 2030s. Matti Nijonen, a professor of Chinese culture and economy at the University of Lapland, said, "I think China increasingly finds itself in between a rock and a hard place. I think they are very carefully monitoring now what they're doing and what kind of reactions this has created. I think it must have surprised China how this united all the Western powers. And now it turns out that even countries like Kazakhstan are turning and criticizing what Putin did." Nijonen also noted that while on one hand China is moving toward a closer relationship with Russia, almost a majority of the other nations are turning against Russia, thus creating a difficult situation for China. Let's wrap up with a SpaceX Starbase update, where they're initiating some major upgrades in their production facility. We know that SpaceX teams have changed the conventional norm of stacking rockets horizontally. They've assembled their Starship and Super Heavy booster almost completely vertically. The cutting, shaping, and welding of stainless steel sheets into steel rings are carried out in the three massive tents they've built. In fact, the assembly of ring, dome, and nose cone are all carried out in those three tents. Presently, the SpaceX team continues with rapidity for the completion of their largest and tallest Starship assembly bay. But according to reports, SpaceX is on its way to construct a new, permanent, flat-ceiling Starship factory. As per reports, they've already physically relocated a smaller tent, which was most probably used for cutting and shaping metal sheets. Report says that SpaceX has partially completed the foundation of a massive building, which is assumed to be meant for an upgraded Starship factory. According to RGV Aerial Photography, this new building will not be mere expansion of the capacity of tents, rather it will be a permanent building which may replace the operational Starbase tents. Sources state that the newer building with 250 meters length, 120 meters width, and 18 meters height will cover an area of 28,000 square meters and will provide almost 2.5 times as much covered floor space over Starbase's 3 tents. Being a flat-ceiling factory, it will have a good advantage over the tents in matters of larger space for ring and nose section assembly.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.